Nicholas Hoare. On this occasion, we have two books to review concurrently, both of them featuring Italian settings, totally different from the one from the other, and both of them a delight. The first is a gardening book which is not a gardening book at all. It is called Paradise of Exiles, and it is subtitled The Anglo-American Gardens of Florence. This is a book which should have been written many moons ago and hasn't been. And I welcome it with open arms because it fills a large gap in horticultural history in that lovely country. It features the high end, I admit, but at the same time the more interesting gardens of Italy, and includes such people as Sir Harold Acton. La Pietra, of course, is legendary. It features Bernard Berenson. There's an article on Lady Paget's house, and so on. It's a name-dropping extraordinaire, but it is gossipy, it is gardeny, it is immensely entertaining, and it is done in a digestible form which essentially encompasses as much photography as it does text. This of its type is extremely interesting history, and it's rather fun for me particularly to see something like this because the exiles, and there were exiles in many cases, the Sitwells, the Actons, you name them, really deserve a memorial of this nature, and they finally got it. So Paradise of Exiles, The Anglo-American Gardens of Florence, and the author, God bless her, is one Katie Campbell. The second book, also set in Italy, is at the opposite end of the spectrum, and that is by a very interesting, not-so-naive traveller called Matthew Frank. Matthew Gavin Frank, and the book concerned is called Barolo. And this young man took it upon himself to travel to Italy in search of love, heat, vino, and the art of living in the country, in the middle of nowhere, in a population of 650 people. Barolo is not a populous part of Italy, but the wines coming out of it are legendary. And he went to work in a community, became part of that community, and wrote this handsome little book called Barolo, which is published improbably by the University of Nebraska Press, not the sort of thing you're about to find every day, but which is a really gentle example of literary travel at its best. And if you love red wine, you're going to love this book. He has written intelligently, tongue-in-cheek. He met a remarkably pretty little girl there as well, which helped, I think. And as a result, he's written, as it were, a memorial to a time in his life which obviously he will never forget. This is light reading, just like many Italian wines are light to drink. You shouldn't look at it as anything dense or heavy, but at the same time, as literary travel goes, this is one of the best, and I'm delighted to welcome Barolo by Matthew Gavin Frank, along with Paradise of Exiles, as the two Italian tomes for this evening. Good night.